Hi, I'm Yvonne Venegas. I am a photographer from Tijuana, Mexico. We're here in Mexico City at Museo Arte Carrillo Gil, where I have a solo show titled Nunca Serás Más Joven Que Este Día, which is You'll Never Be Younger Than This Day. And we're going to give you a little tour. I like to photograph things that happen between the perfect moment and the mistake. There's something in between those two moments that's ambiguous and it's unexpected most of the time. Another part is a social class, a specific social class. I'm interested in people who have a very clear idea of how they want to be seen. So sometimes that doesn't have to do with specifically the middle class or the upper class, but it's around those two sort of parts, no? I mean, I come from Tijuana, which is a strange place because we have the best of both worlds, I guess. We have a bit of the U.S., we have a bit of Mexico, and I've never actually felt like I have both my feet on the ground in one place. I think that I see it more as a combination of American and Mexican when I see the Mexican culture. So I think about class, and I think about such wealthy people living in this country being at something a bit absurd, and I like to see the more as something that could be fictional. I like to see things that could be a movie, that could be a movie set. Yeah, Julieta became her first pop album came out in 2004 or something like that. I grew up with an identical twin sister, and she's we always had a intense relationship. We were kind of put into roles, like the good girl and the bad girl kind of roles. So we didn't grow up a happy couple. We both knew that we were gonna, our dream was to do well in whatever we chose to do. We had decided it was gonna be photography and music. We didn't think it was gonna be anything else. Through our work, through finding a tool, we were identified. People could identify us. People, we weren't going to be the good and the bad anymore. We were actually going to be something else. We were going to be Julieta, the musician, and Yvonne, the photographer. And that kind of gave us a sort of space to have a friendship in. Precisely when my sister came out with her first pop album and everybody knew who she was, we had a fight. And we didn't see each other for a long time. So we were kind of mad at each other, and I kept running into her image constantly, not only on the wall, but also in people. The way they looked at me, they thought I was her. It was almost like I realized I could never escape. I couldn't just retire to my quarters and just forget about it. It just became sort of this condition that I was living with. So that gave me a whole theory about celebrity. I mean, that experience, it was just too intense. Just the idea of losing my private space was just a bit too much. I never thought about it before. I never thought that when I was out on the street, I had a private space. So, and the problem was that I wasn't even a celebrity. It was just like this consequence of my sister's celebrity that just kind of started to happen to me.
She apologizes to this date to me, like, oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Like, you know.
It's no coincidence that when that was happening, I did Inédito.
We got access to a soap opera called Rebelde.
No, I did the series that Fundación Televisa invited me to do, so it was perfect timing. And I had a lot of thoughts about it.
Inédito can also mean unphotoshopped or something that hasn't been worked on. And Televisa tends to Photoshop a lot. And, you know, the official image of Televisa is very different from the one that I'm showing. So it was really nice to have the opportunity to work with these actors that are usually seen in a very finished way, in sort of my way.
I keep feeling like someone from Tijuana, you know what I mean? It's like I keep feeling like this girl from Tijuana that is doing what she really wants to do. And I think that that's what I get from, you know, from other, like, even students or people who like the work that we do or whatever. It's like I kind of see that I can only go in one direction, which is the one that I have decided to follow. And that's I think that's how, if people see me like that, they got the right idea. If they don't, I don't really know.